So hello guys, so we are going to solve this question list comparisons in the Python series again because some guys commented that they wanted the one liner solutions and the list comparison method solution. So first of all, we will go fastly, we will take these things, what is the problem, actual problem is. So here they are giving these three, four inputs x, y, z and n. Basically these x, y, z are the numbers. With these numbers, with these values, we have to create a set. Okay, so we will see this. So if our number is 1, we can make the set of elements 0 to that number itself. If here the element was 3, then we can take the elements from 0 to 3. Means in the set we can take these elements 0 to 3. Now here we have element 1, so we can take the elements from 0 to 1 only. Maximum we can take 0 to 1, maximum we can take the two numbers. So these basically x, y, z are the values which represents a set. In from that set we are going to use the values to create our output. So now these are three sets, x, y, z, x, y, z, using x, y, z number because all the values are 1. Now we have to make this list of these possible combinations. Now we can use one element from each set. We can use 0, 0, 0 to perform our expected output. We have to make a set of elements using these all values. Now again here, like here you can see these are the sets that are created using these values. In the first 0, 0, 1, then they use 0, 0 and 1, and then 0, 1 and again 0. These are all the possible combinations, like permutations of the list using these ranges 0 to 1. And lastly, finally, this 2 is useful to find that which elements we have to remove. Remove all the arrays that sum to n. So we have to remove the list such arrays whose sum is equal to n. Our n is now 2, so we have to remove the arrays such whose sum is 2. Now we will remove these arrays because the sum of these arrays is 2. So in this condition we have to find the things. So first of all, I will find this whole set. How can we find this set using one liner solution? So now here they have taken these inputs x, y, z and n. So first of all, I will find all possible values for 1. So I will take here 1, yes. So yes is equal to, I will iterate it like so, I am iterating the x in range because x is a value and I wanted the possible set. Like if our x is 1, then we here I missed the things to print as. So because we will go simply by debugging all the way, so now we will see what it will give the values. So here it is only giving 0. Okay, so here we have to add the things 1 because the range takes up to that element. So that's why we have to add the 1 in x range. So now our x is 1, then our possible values we can use in this set are 0 and 1. So now the main thing is we have to create the array in such things, means 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. To make that condition happens, so we will take here I comma j. So this is our set, expected set. Now we are going to do only two things, then we will see for another thing. Now I will iterate the j for j in range. So now I will take a range of values from y plus 1. So why it was giving an error? J in Yeah, I think it is good. So now I think we should get the set of elements. Yeah, this is the same thing that I was expected. So we are getting this 0, 0, 1, 1 because of this i. Because here we are iterating the things 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, and these second element 0 1 0 1 that we are getting because of this second iteration of j. So now we can find these all arrays using, again we can use, now we are going again ij, now we will add again one element k, and here we will iterate our k for k in range. Now range will be our z because we want to iterate the possible values of z. Now we will run the code. So now I think we are much closer to our expected value. So this is the thing, these are all the possible conditions, all the possible permutations that we can make. Now the main thing is that we have to check the sum of these all elements, sum of I, j, k. Why it is giving error? Not, it is not an error. So if our sum of I, j, k is equal to n, then we are not going to add the things, we are not going to add an array, this array into the array. So here we will write that if I plus j plus k is not equal to n. This is because our sum means, now our I will be 0 for the iteration. If you see the iteration, so it will check the sum of these three numbers. If our sum of three numbers is not equal to n, then only they are adding this set. So this is important thing. So now I will run the code, what it will happen. I think it should work fine. Yeah, so the basically this was the one liner solution. So we can directly put these things here. Lastly I will say once again what is happening here. Control C, Control X and Control V. Can it work? I think it should work fine. So why it is taking so much time? Yeah, is this working? Yeah, so we will submit the code now. So the basically the thing is that we are iterating all the possible values using the ranges. So this is basic operation that we know, but we are making the set, we are creating an array, an array we can call it list, using this I, j, k, and we are iterating all these three values with their ranges respectively here, I, j and k. Now and here this is main condition, here we are checking that the sum of I, j and k is not equal to n. Then we are, if this condition is satisfied, then only we are adding this set. So that was the thing. So this was the one liner solution. So thank you guys.